I'm going to say something very, very, very important. You know, I'm not the only one, Lasmet, thank God, because Lasmet means something different. Lasmet is still a family business. It means my two brothers, Bruno and Carlos, and myself, we own Spinetta. And thank God we have also my son Andrea is working hard in the cellar. He's a wine, the farmer winemaker in the cellar. I have two nephews, two nieces. Okay, they're working with us. It's big family. Family business. I like to say that because all together we try to control, to have control of the vineyard and the cellar also of the business of Spinetta. It means my brother Bruno is working in Tuscany. He's taking care of Tuscany property. He's doing everything there. He's doing everything. Okay, he's following this new project we started in 2001 in Tuscany. There we are doing the best with the indigenous grapes. You know, we like indigenous grapes. We like this is great for Tuscany. For us, it means okay, Sangiovese, it's Colorino, Pugnolo, Vermentino, those varietals. We don't work with any international grapes in Tuscany, and we don't work with any international grapes in Piedmont. What it means that, okay? Piedmont for us, it means, of course, it means Nebbiolo, Barbera, Moscato, Dolcetto, those varieties that are typical from Piedmont. The only grape we are using are not indigenous grapes, they are okay. The wine, the grape for sparkling wine production means okay, contratto, because contratto is something different. Contratto it means a Champenoise, it means Merlot Champenoise, it means Merlot Classico. If you want to do the best job, if you want to make great sparkling wine, you have to work with Pinot Noir and Chardonnay. But all the rest, La Spinetta is all about indigenous grapes. We bought this property in 2000. One in Tuscany, because we believe in Sangiovese, we believe in those varietals, we believe in Vermentino, we believe in this great beautiful grapes. We love Brunello, we love all those type of varietals, and all together we try to work with the same philosophy, the same mentality. Everything is about farming. Everything about is about organic stuff in the vineyard. Okay, we treat them our environment the best we can do, and we do very small production. And we try to give the fantastic interpretation of Sangiovese, Vermentino, Prugnolo, Gentile in Tuscany, like we do the same in Piedmont with Barbera, with Moscato, with Nebbiolo, with those varietals. Piedmont for us, not just Stardere, Gallina, Vajrano. And Campè. Piedmont for us is also Calipiam, unbelievable wine, beautiful Barbera, unbelievable Barbera. I started with Calipiam. My first vintage Calipiam was 82. Think about that. In the time I was very young, I was completely different person. I was tall, I was blonde, blue eyes, different person. Now I'm more Italian, no? You know, we talk about long time ago. I want to tell you, long time ago it means quite 40 years ago, more than that. And Calipiam, in the time when we started Calipiam, the vines they were very young. Now the vines they are 40, 45 years old. It means it's beautiful, great Barbera interpretation. It's something you can really enjoy, something you can drink when you're young, you can keep in the cellar for a long time. With Calipiam, we change the perception of Barbera in the world. I can say that. Calipiam is one of the most important Barbera in the United States, for example. In China, in Japan, in Germany, in Italy too. It means, okay, we change a lot because sometimes Barbera is not easy. Barbera could be very rustic. Rustic, it means, okay, could be very low in alcohol. The acid is very high. You know, it's very aggressive. Something you cannot enjoy to drink. Otherwise, there are some other Barberas that are a little bit too big. It means 15, 60% alcohol. Why? You don't recognize the grapes anymore. You don't recognize the variety anymore because it's just big wine. And sometimes it's very hooky. It's again, everything is about balance. Okay, Barbera could be great, beautiful wine, enough power, enough weight, not too heavy, and not too acidic. It could be something you can really enjoy. And don't forget this, Barbera is everyday wine. In Piedmont, people they drink Barbera or Dolcetto every day. Every day. They don't drink Barbaresco, Stardere, Gallina, or Campè, Barolo every day. They drink Barbera. And it's fantastic everyday wine because it's easy with Barbera to have great combination with food. If you are in the kitchen, like I'm in the kitchen now, I don't have to spend 3 hours in the kitchen to do something special because I want to open and to drink glass of Barbera. No, please, I can open my fridge. Okay? And then I can find something there, no? Capo-slice of prosciutto, a piece of Parmigiano cheese. That's enough. It's enough. Barbera is fantastic wine because it's everyday wine. As our Cadipian Barbera is one of the most important expression of Barbera. Easy to enjoy, easy to drink. Of course, from there we do also from Barbera we do also something different. We do Barbera La Magdalena, small production, 6,000 bottles, one of the most important single vineyard for Barbaresco production. But we do Barbera Galina there, very elegant. But this Barbera is getting everything from this beautiful single vineyard Galina. It's getting everything. It's complexity, also approachable. Yes, everything is aging very well. I just opened one bottle of Barbera Galina. 96, it was my first vintage. It really is not wine anymore, it's a monument. It's a monument. He has everything there, you know. And we bought the property in 2003 in Barbera d'Asti area, and we do Barbera d'Asti Superior. You know, the beautiful Barbera d'Asti expression. The vines are very old. Okay, now the vines, I think they are 85, 90 years old vines. Something unbelievable. 40% of the vines, they are still pre-philosopher. Pre-philosopher means very old. That wine has a lot of complexity. That is something, I would say something, maybe I'm wrong, but after 10, 15 years, those Barbera tastes like Barbaresco or Barolo. This Barbera tastes like Barbaresco or Barolo, for sure. It's beautiful wine. Big, structure, acidity, complexity, mineral, he has everything. This is Barbera. And don't forget this, Piemonte is not all about Nebbiolo. We have so many other beautiful varietals. Barbera, Dolcetto, Moscato, Fresa, or Arnaise, or those varieties. They are beautiful varieties. Piemonte is something very complex. It can give to you so many different options to enjoy Piemonte wines, to enjoy Langan wines, you know? And we do Moscato. Moscato was our first wine we made in Piemonte. Really, it was 1977. Now it's 40, maybe, okay? Oh my God, long time ago. But it was our first wine. And Moscato d'Asti is the only Moscato you have to drink. I don't talk about La Spinetta Moscato d'Asti because I think it's still one of the best Moscato, but there are so many of the great producers, they do beautiful job in Moscato. You know why? Because Moscato d'Asti is the only Moscato with balance. He has great acidity, great minerality, sweetness. It is not too sweet. It's something you can enjoy. You can drink one glass, but you want to have another glass immediately. Because it's not heavy, it's not rich, it's not too sweet, it's not too dense. It doesn't have this kind of density. This is Moscato d'Asti. I'm producing Moscato since a long time. I'm trying so many Moscato from different hair, but Moscato d'Asti is the only one he has this kind of thing, okay? This kind of, it's something you can really want to enjoy. It's also breakfast wine. Think about that, 5% alcohol. Okay, in the morning you can drink Moscato your breakfast without any problem. This is La Spinetta in Piemonte. You know, we do so many different wines, but all the wines are made with the same philosophy, farmer philosophy. Think about that. Farmer philosophy is something very special, it's something very important. It means, okay, we don't have to push, you have to follow, you know, the season, you have to follow the nature, like this, you have to follow. And you know, especially now, okay, you can see there's so many problems, but this thing, the agriculture, the farmer philosophy, and everything, our environment, they can tell us what we have to do. And really, well, we are very proud about that, because we sell a lot of Barbaresco around the world, but we can do also a very good job with our Barberas and the Moscato and the other thing in Langa Nebbiolo. And another good thing about La Spinetta, he doesn't buy 1 kilo of fruit. All the fruit come from our estate. All the fruit come from our vineyard, because it's the only way for us to control the quality from the beginning, when we prune. After that, we follow everything. Okay, we do green harvesting, we harvesting. It's only way for us to control the quality. Toscany, for me, it's something new, because we just bought the property in 2001, but it's something very exciting too. They have a beautiful, unbelievable variety there too, really. I can tell you, I'm so excited about Tuscany. I was so excited from the beginning. I'm still very excited right now, because in Tuscany, you can do something very special. You can do something very important with great single vineyard, old vine Sangiovese, but you can do something also much more approachable. We started, think about that, we started in 2012 with rosé. Oh my God, I said, I have to do rosé now? No, I was not so familiar with rosé. I said, okay, if you are doing rosé, we tried a couple years before, but in 2012, it was our first vintage in the market. And the brandy was 50%, Sangiovese, 50% Prugno Gentile. But we didn't do this, the normal Italian rosé. The regular Italian rosé, what it means that, okay? Normally in that time, not anymore, because thank God the producer changed the way to understand rosé, to give great rosé interpretation in the glass. But at the time, producers used to do rosé when the vintage was bad. But the vintage, if the vintage is bad, it's bad for rosé, it's bad for Sangiovese, it's bad for everything, okay? Or otherwise they used to do rosé, 15% alcohol rosé, dark in color, and they used to sell rosé after 3 years in the cellar. It doesn't work like that. We did this kind of rosé interpretation in Tuscany in different way. 12% alcohol, very low in alcohol, great acidity, great minerality, beautiful color, something people they understand, because in the world, when the people they think about rosé, they really want to have something enjoyable, something easy to drink, something you can drink with different kind of food. You can drink one bottle before to start to eat something. And this is Aspetta Rosé. And from there, it became very famous everywhere in the world. I'm so proud about that, because after us, mostly of the rosé producers now, they are producing rosé in this way. It means we are building now the new way to make Italian rosé. Okay? Not the old way, dark, 50% alcohol or bad rosé. No, now we can find great rosé from Tuscany, from Italy. Okay? And that rosé is very famous. I want to try with you guys this rosé, because it's something very important for us. And this is 50% Sangiovese and 50% Prugno Gentile. Why this blend? Because Sangiovese is giving the power, is giving the shoulder, is giving the character. From Tuscany, you can see, you can taste the Tuscan character, but, you know, the Prugnolo is giving the aromas, it's something lighter, it's something giving to you, or so many different things in your nose. You really want to enjoy and to drink this wine. Like I said to you, it could be a very dangerous wine, because you can drink two bottles before to start to eat. Not one, two bottles, really. Yeah, and 2019, it was beautiful, beautiful vintage for the, you know. We harvested this fruit very early. We do the harvest last year, 2019. We did the first week of September, you know, and the fruit was ripe for rosé. It means not even 13% alcohol, okay, less than 13% alcohol, because the rosé, the alcohol rosé, it doesn't have to be 14-15%, okay? It must be something you really, really want to drink, to enjoy, and you can drink two bottles, not just one. This is not a thing about my idea about wine, okay? You know? Here's the rosé. The rhino is there, okay? Don't forget this, okay? Rhino. If you want to have great wine from Piedmont, Tuscany, rhino is so important. It's not the most important thing, but it's very important, okay? You know, the color, very light in color. It's kind of this kind of onion peel, no? In the aromas, you can have so many different things. But for sure, you are in Tuscany. You are not somewhere else. You are in Tuscany, because this wine is made in Tuscany with Tuscan varietals. This is so important for us to give this kind of sense of. Oh my God! I'm sorry, my English is so bad. But you know, when you close your eyes to smell this wine, you are in Tuscany. You walk in the vineyard. You walk and you can feel this aroma from the Tuscan rosmarino or something like that. Wow, it's good for aperitif, it's good with food, with seafood, it's good for with everything, anything. Cheers with Aspetta Rosé.